Hello, welcome to the channel, The Royal Chemistry, all about chemistry. In today's video, we are going to discuss about electrochemical principles of metallurgy. It's in class 12 chemistry, unit 1, metallurgy. Let me start the topic, electrochemical principle of metallurgy. Before enter into the topic, we should know what is electrochemical principle. The electrochemical principle of metallurgy are effective in the reduction of metal ions to their respective metals in their solutions or molten state. Usually the reduction is carried out by electrolysis process. This electrochemical principles also find some applications in metallurgical process. Let us see that what are the applications of this electrochemical principles. What are the applications? Active metals such as potassium, sodium, magnesium and aluminium. These are all active metals. These metals cannot able to reduce by carbon. That is, the reduction of oxides of these active metals cannot be done by the carbon. And it is not thermodynamically feasible too. What it means, cannot possible? What's the other meaning of this feasibility? Impossible or unattainable or unachievable, all those meanings you can take it. Then in what way we can extract these active metals? The active metals are extracted by using electrochemical methods. Now let's see about this electrochemical method in this video. Active metal salts are taken in a fused form, that it should be in the fused form or in a solution form. The example I given here is potassium. It's in the fused form as well as in the volcano form. So fused form as well as the volcano form, both are presented here. So the metal, active metal, should be taken in a fused form or in a solution form, or you can say it is in a molten form. Next thing is, how do we reduce the metal ion? That's the question. How do we reduce this metal ion? The metal ion present can be reduced by treating it with some suitable reducing agent. So the metal ions or else can be reduced by electrolysis. So either you can go with reducing agent or else it can be reduced by electrolysis process. For that we should know some reactivity series of metals. Let's see that now. The reactivity series of metals are given here. What are they? Sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, tin, lead, which are all present above the hydrogen. They are all active metals. Let us see the Gibbs free energy change for the electrolysis process. Here the formula needed for that is del G naught is equal to minus N F E naught, where N is the number of electrons involved in the reduction process. F is Faraday, it's a constant, 96495 coulomb. Electrode potential of the redox couple, E naught is electrode potential of the redox couple. Now for finding out the E naught value, we need to remember the electrochemical series. So what is this electrochemical series? Let's see. The electrochemical series is a list that describes the arrangement of elements in order of their increasing electrode potential. arrangement of elements in order of their increasing electrode potential. Let's see that electrochemical series now. The electrochemical series, we should make it above hydrogen and below hydrogen. Okay, so above hydrogen, the metal on the top which having negative value of standard adduction potential have the tendency to lose electron readily. Okay, so these are all active metals, and the other one, the non-metals on the bottom, that is below hydrogen, having high positive values of standard reduction potential have the tendency to accept electron readily. Example, copper, you can say, whose E naught value is plus 0.337 volt. Here the electrochemical series is given for you. You can see that is about above hydrogen and below hydrogen. You can check it out. Above, from the starting, you have negative values of E naught, and when coming down, you have positive E naught values. So the electrochemical series, you can check out. Some E naught values are given separately for you for your reference. So potassium negative value, we have all metals have, active metals have negative value, E naught value. Now hydrogen, standard hydrogen value is zero, and then below that we have positive values. The substance which are stronger reducing agent than hydrogen are placed above hydrogen, okay, in the series and have a negative value of standard reduction potential. You understand this? So hydrogen ku mele irukra ellarume strong reducing agent, avangalukku E naught value negative a irukum. All those substances which have positive value, that is strong oxidizing agents, which are lying below the hydrogen, that is they are placed below hydrogen, they have E naught value is positive in the series. Okay, so more positive E naught value you will get it, those substance which is present below hydrogen. So what do you mean by reducing agent? First we should know that reducing agent is the substance which reduces others. That much means that it gives electrons to it. Okay, oxidizing agent is the one that must mean that it takes electron from it. So what is the E naught value? How to calculate this E naught value? We have the formula. E naught is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. That is, the electrode potential of the electrodes are taken as reduction potentials. This is the formula to find out E naught value. Okay, now where we are going to substitute this E naught value? We have the formula. Del G naught is equal to minus NF E naught value. So நீங்க இந்த E naught value வந்து உங்களுக்கு பாசிட்டிவா கிடைக்கும்போது இங்க சப்ஸ்டிட்யூட் பண்ணீங்கன்னா யூ வில் கெட் நெகட்டிவ் டெல்ஜி நாட் வேல்யூ. ஸோ இஃப் யூ கெட் த நெகட்டிவ் டெல்ஜி நாட் வேல்யூ, அந்த ரிடக்ஷன் பொட்டன்ஷியல் வந்து ஸ்பான்டேனியஸாக இருக்கும். ஓகேவா? தட்ஸ் த திங். ஸோ நவ் வென் மோர் ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல் இஸ் ஆடட் டு த சொல்யூஷன், திஸ் இஸ் த கான்செப்ட். வென் மோர் ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல் இஸ் மோர் ரியாக்டிவ், த மெட்டல் இஸ் ஸோ ரியாக்டிவ் மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் ஆடட் டு த சொல்யூஷன் மீன் கண்டெய்னிங் த ரிலேட்டிவ் லெஸ் ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல் ஆன், த மோர் ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல் வில் கோ இன் டு த சொல்யூஷன். Got it? Yes. When more reactive metal ion is added to the solution containing less reactive metal ion, the more reactive metal will goes into the solution. Let us discuss about some examples here. What example I have taken for you is zinc and silver. Zinc which is present above hydrogen in the electrochemical series and silver present below hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So zinc undergoes oxidation whose E naught value is minus 0.763. Zn gives Zn 2 plus plus 2 electron. It is in anode compartment. Okay. Then for silver, it gets oxidized. Zinc is oxidized. Here silver, it get reduced by getting the electron from the zinc. And Ag plus plus 2 electron gives Ag, whose E naught value plus. So here the standard potential of this is calculated for zinc and silver. we are substituting the silver value as 0.799 and then with the zinc minus 0.76. We have formula minus, so we are getting E naught value positive 1.562 volt. If we get the positive E naught value, if you substitute this E naught value in del G naught calculation, you will get a negative G naught value. That shows that this reaction is spontaneous if you connect zinc as an anode and silver as an cathode. If you make it in a reverse, this reaction will not be possible because we will get E naught value as negative. So we have to maintain E naught value as positive always. Let's see the next example here is, I'm going to use three reactive metals here, zinc, copper and silver. So the reactivity series decreases from zinc to the silver takes place. Let us see the next example I'm going to discuss here is copper and the silver. Let us see now, in the copper and silver, copper reacts with the silver, you will get copper 2 plus ion plus Hg. That's the solution here, which is more reactive metal. We have a statement already, I told you that when more reactive metal, that is more reactive metal is added to the solution containing the relatively less reactive metal ion, more reactive metal ion goes into the solution. Okay, more reactive ion or the solution kulla poiduvanga. So inga namma copper um silver eduthirukom, we are getting Cu2 plus ion. What it means, copper displaces silver but copper goes into the solution. So which is more reactive here? Copper is more reactive. So copper is more reactive metal, that's why it goes into the solution. So now check out the oxidation state of copper here for this equation. Copper plus 2Ag gives 2Cu2 plus plus Ag. Here for fulvinated solution, if you check copper oxidation state, 0 to plus 2 oxidized, and silver is plus 1 to 0, it gets reduced. Okay, so if you check out the E naught values for the next example I'm going to discuss here is zinc and copper combination. It is called as Daniell cell. So zinc is connected in the anode, copper is connected in the cathode. Because zinc is present above hydrogen, copper is present below hydrogen. So see the E naught value, minus 0.76 for zinc and plus 0.34 for the copper. Now let's see the overall reaction here. Zinc plus Cu2 plus gives Zn2 plus plus copper. So here the reducing agent is zinc, and which is oxidized here is product is zinc 2 plus ion. So more reactive metal goes into the solution. So zinc is the more reactive metal here. So here I am going to discuss now, what about the E naught value for the zinc and the copper. So zinc is in the anode, copper in the cathode. Zinc undergoes oxidation, copper undergoes reduction. The overall reaction, if you calculate E naught cell, you are getting 1.1 volt. E naught is positive, so automatically del G naught value will be negative, so the reaction is spontaneous. I am going to give some ideas to remember the reactivity series of metals in this video. Let us watch. Kings cannot make a zebra iron-like. His cause, silvery gate palace. Potassium, calcium, sodium make M for magnesium, A for aluminium, Z for zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, silver, then gold and platinum. Hope you will understand my video, Electrochemical Principles of Metallurgy. My next video is about Hall-Erold process. It is an electrochemical extraction of aluminium. We will see it soon. Subscribe my channel, comment and like and share with your friends. Keep watching. Thank you for watching.